Happy Homebrew Day.
Cheers. I got a homebrew.
Yes. So yesterday did a brew on the new system and still got a few more kinks to work out. I gotta shorten the hoses. You'll notice in the video that these are pretty long, so I just gotta chop them down a bit. I think we pretty much got it. The control panel is working amazingly. I can't be happier with the control panel. I got, the only thing I didn't put on it was an interlock, which is never cool. There's no kids that are gonna be turning this on and off. It's all gonna be, so I know what to check for before I turn it on. So I just make sure that I don't plug in the element that I'm not using at the moment. So yeah, got that going. In the garage, sorry about the echo, but it's about the only place personal I can go to at the moment. Up around, I'm gonna start putting some heavy-duty shelving just to hold the brewing equipment, and I got a bunch of containers that I have, all your brewing supplies and all the stuff that you can use during your brew day that I'll put in. So, yeah, kind of nice. Finally moved into the new place. Finally out of that old place. Finally able to actually do the electric brew. So, the reason I'm reaching down here is I got my pumps, and if you notice, I have them on a long 2x6. And the reason why I did that is you'll see in the video where you'll see the pump mounted like this. I can just slide it right in between the 2x6s that are already there, and it just stays put, which is nice. And when I'm done, slip it out. I don't have to attach anything to the workbench at all. Let's go find a way to put those somewhere where they don't get knocked around or knocked over or whatever and broken. So yeah, so on with the brew day. I'm not gonna narrate anything. I just went ahead and just started do some editing here, and we'll go through kind of the brew day. But it ended okay, and enjoy, guys. We'll see you in a little bit. Okay. So what I made was, I think I called it the, see, it had Mosaic and Amarillo, so I call it the Mosarillo 20, because I had some Crystal 20 in there on the 10 pounds of two-row base malt. So, yeah. Probably my next video is going to be more in-depth on the actual brewing process with the new system, so I'll go through the parts and all that stuff next time. So I started off the day yesterday just going through, just sorting out if I had any leaks, if I had any major issues, and I got through doing the testing and I had, it wasn't even noon. I said, screw it. I just went to the brew hut and bought, you know, some hops and some malt, and then got some USO4 to make us a little ale. So yeah, that was it, man. So look for the next video. Thanks for tuning in. Remember, keep rocking, keep doing what you're doing, and never stop. Brewed. Rock on.